In this video, we are going to understand the phenomena of refraction. We have seen the reflection and then the loss of reflection. We learned that light not only shows reflection, but it also shows refraction and dispersion. So in this video, we are going to look at the refraction of light. What is refraction of light? In simple terms, refraction of light is simply the bending of light. So whenever light travels from one transparent medium to the other, the light as it passes through at the boundary, it shows bending. So the bending of light is in simple terms called refraction. Let us look at the diagram. So we have two rays here. One is an incident ray and this is medium 1 and this is medium 2. Both of them are transparent. And when the light is going from medium 1 to medium 2, both of them are transparent and then incident ray will bend and then come out as refracted ray. So this is called incident ray and this is called refracted ray, and the angle between incident ray and the normal to the surface is called angle of incidence. And then angle between refracted ray and normal is called angle of refraction. So those are the few terms that needs to be understood. Why does the light bend, or why does it do so? That's an important question that needs to be answered. It is because the speed travels with different speeds. The light travels with different speeds in different media. We have seen that. We have seen that light travels at one speed in gases, with another speed in liquids, and with another speed in solids. Even within the solids, if the density is different, then light travels with different speeds, because the speed of light depends upon the optical density of the medium. So if these two are different media, and then if both of them will have obviously a different optical density, they will not have the same optical density. If their optical density is different, then obviously the speed of light would be different. Because of the difference in the speed of light, the light suffers or shows the phenomena called refraction. It is a very important one marker. So why does the light show refraction? Right, light shows refraction because of the difference in speed of light. So another important property is called, or the principle is called, Fermat principle. I am sure that you must not have heard about it, but it is not there as a part of your syllabus, but that is called Fermat principle. That principle says light will take the shortest route possible. The other property the light has is, for example, there are two media which both of them have 1 kilometer in length. For example, to travel 1 kilometer length in one media, if it takes 8 minutes, and then in another media, it has to take the same 8 minutes. It cannot take more, it cannot take less. That is the property of the light. So that is what it follows. So to do that, we know in the medium 1, the speed is different, and the medium 2, the speed is different. To compensate for the speed, it will take the shortest route. For example, we will know that this is an incident ray, and then in the other media, if the speed is faster compared to this medium, then it will take a long path, because it has more time here, because it is traveling fast, so speed is increasing, so it needs to increase the length, so that the time will be constant. So in the formula, we know that velocity into time is equal to distance. It needs to maintain the constant time. So what should it do? It should increase or decrease the distance, because the velocity is changing with the media. We do not have control over it. As soon as we change the media, velocity of the light is changing. But the Fermat, according to the Fermat principle, it needs to maintain the constant time in both the media. Since if the velocity is increasing, then what it will do is the distance also will increase. So that means it will bend a lot and take a longer path instead of traveling in a straight line. So the straight line would be the shortest path. So it bends more and more, then it takes a longer path, so it takes a lot of time. So to compensate for the difference in speeds of light, it will bend in one way or the other way. We will look at that in the next video. but otherwise understand that the refraction of the light is because of the difference in speed of light. And then we have seen one difference that we need to note between the reflection and the refraction is, in terms of reflection, we have seen there are two media. One is a transparent media, another one is an opaque media. So the light is bouncing off at the surface. But the difference is, one is opaque, this is not transparent. Had it been transparent, the light would have traveled through. Refraction is occurring between two media, but both of them are transparent. So that is the difference. In reflection, one is transparent and another one is opaque. But in refraction, both of them are transparent. But the speed of light in both of them is different. But otherwise, both are transparent. That difference we need to note between reflection and refraction. Another point that needs to be noted is, during refraction, we also find a partially reflected ray. For example, this is the diagram for the refraction. So I have a ray which is incident, and then it will bend, and then this is a refracted ray. You also have a partially reflected ray at the surface. So this is my surface, or the boundary between the two media. Here, not all light will travel through, because none of the media are 100% transparent. So some of the light will definitely bounce back at the surface. This is called partially reflected ray. Since it is reflected, so this is called partially reflected ray. This is called incident ray, this is called transparent ray, this is called refracted ray, this is called partially reflected ray, and then this is called normal. So the angle between incident ray and then the normal is called angle of incidence and represented by I. The angle between the normal and this is the normal and this is the refracted ray, that is called angle of refraction, that is also denoted by angle R. Do not get confused between angle of reflection and angle of refraction. Both are represented by R, but only difference is one ray is reflected, another ray is refracted. But otherwise, that is also represented by angle R. So this is the terminology and this is the understanding that you need to have. In the next video, we are going to learn about the refraction, that is the bending of light towards the normal and away from the normal.